Hello guys, this is Jeffrey Hidalgo from ABS-CBN Lifestyle and welcome to another episode of Pillow Talk. And just like always, you can leave your comments and questions for our guests right down below. And if you missed this episode, you can log on to our website at that's lifestyle.abs-cbn.com. Did I get it right again? lifestyle.abs-cbn.com. And follow us also on all our social media profiles on Instagram, Twitter, and that's at ABS-CBN Lifestyle. All right, let's meet our guests this afternoon. Having formed their band early last year, these UK-based boys went from having their music featured on the hit dating show Love Island to selling out headlining tours and collaborating with Lil Mix, Julian Michaels, oh, I love Julian Michaels, and some of the biggest names in music. It's their first time touring in the Philippines, so let's give a warm welcome to Nathan Lambert, Ryan Meany, and Alec McGarry of New Rules! Checked in on your Spotify, it says like an Englishman, an Irishman, and Alec.
Yeah, so, I'm an Englishman.
Okay.
I'm an Irishman.
Okay. I am an Alec.
Why?
Apparently, I get my own species.
So. Oh, okay.
You get it if you knew him.
Okay.
It's a baby deer, actually. Usually that's the bio, but what's that bio? Is it on Instagram?
It's on Instagram.
Yeah. On Instagram, it's Englishman, Irishman, baby deer, because we think Alec looks a little bit like Bambi.
What do you think? Hilarious. Kind of. Let's see. I don't know. Maybe if you can like try to mimic Bambi, like.
Moo.
No. Dude, I'm pretty sure that's not what Bambi sounds like. But anyway.
And that's why he's an Alec.
Okay. So, how did you develop your interest in music?
Yeah, I mean, it all started, I guess, when we were younger. So we've got quite musical backgrounds. Mm-hmm. I know Ryan obviously is from Ireland, which means, I mean, everyone in Ireland is musical.
Yeah, you're right.
And then,
just like in the Philippines.
Exactly. Yeah. we just grew up, our parents love music and we love music. We listen to a lot of bands, got learning guitar and singing at an early age. So here we are today.
Mm-hmm. How about you? Like, how did you start getting into music?
Yeah, I picked up a guitar when I was about 10, 11 years old, because I had a talent show at school and I really wanted to impress a girl that was there.
Woo!
I thought the way to do that was playing Hotel California. It didn't work, but at least I'm in a band now.
How about you, Nathan?
Yeah, I was a kid and my dad introduced me to the Beatles.
Oh,
and like I just got like obsessed with bands. And like, so ever since I was like 8 years old, I've been, you know, watching bands on the telly and like, picking up guitar, and just that's all I ever wanted to do. So. Yeah, now I'm doing it.
Right.
Yeah, same. Come from a musical family and started. I just always wanted to play guitar from a young age, so picked that up quite young. Maybe about I was about 8 or 9, and started like learning lots of covers and then like playing in bars and stuff like that, just trying to make a bit of money. But it's good to be writing with these guys now.
Nice. So New Rules is relatively a really fresh band. Like you were just formed last year. How did you guys meet, and how was this? How was New Rules formed?
We actually met on Instagram. So yeah, we're a very Generation Z band.
Okay, nice.
I'd seen a video of Alec on Instagram doing some covers. And so I messaged him and said, do you want to start meeting up and writing some songs?
Awesome.
And
then that time, Alec was living in where?
So I was living at my parents' house, but Nathan and I both kind of live just outside of London. So
okay.
We don't live that far away.
Yeah, we live quite
close.
Oh, alright. Like you.
Yeah, no, not
me. Yeah.
No, he was a difficult one, because we then found him on YouTube, and he took a bit of convincing to come over from Dublin, because he refused to leave.
Yeah.
For some reason, he thinks Dublin's better than London.
It's better than everywhere.
So,
except for the Philippines.
So, okay, if I got this right, you kind of like formed the band on your own.
Yeah, this
that's
is
awesome.
Just like from Instagram and YouTube.
That's awesome.
And like, we've
and Tinder.
Yeah, and and then we just kind of like started meeting up when we became when we became mates. We just kind of like knew we had to be a band. So,
so when was this? Was this just last year or like a few years ago?
It was about a year and a bit now. So Nate found me. So Ryan and I, we used to post videos on YouTube and Instagram. I'm just trying to like a lot of people do that now, I guess,
yes.
to try and get themselves out there. And I guess Nate saw one of my videos and he got in touch with me. Because we didn't live that far away, I was like, yeah, why not? I'll go and see if this guy's legit. Nathan had actually been in a band before, so he had quite a following, and I was starstruck. He's so famous. And yeah, Ryan was kind of just a similar thing. We found like one video on YouTube with him, which we managed to, I don't even know, it was like on an official website because he like, what did you do? It was like a...
Yeah, I got a cover, I did a Hosier song in our track.
Which one?
Someone new. It's probably my
little
one.
One of my favorites.
Alex is a big Hosier fan as well. So he noticed that and and it got me in the band.
Awesome. So who writes the songs? Do you all three of you?
Yeah, it's always different, you know, like usually one of us will have an idea and it could be like a song title or a or like just something on the guitar, and then we'll sit together with the guitar with the producer, and we'll just we'll sit down and we knock it out for an hour or a day,
2 days,
three,
a year.
nice. Okay, so what's keeping you busy nowadays?
Well, we are in Manila. No, I mean lots of things. We're so just heading into 2020. Mm. We've got loads more music coming out soon. So we just finished writing.
Mm.
We did a week in LA and we wrote a bunch of new songs, which we feel really good about.
Yeah.
And then, in like 2-3 weeks time, we've got our own headline tour coming up. And it's our second one. And that's almost sold out now. So we are really, really happy with that. And
so we're also bringing along Inigo Pasquale on that tour.
Nice.
Which is gonna be great.
Nice.
Yeah.
So how was it performing with Inigo here in the Philippines? And how was it like meeting your Filipino fans?
Yeah, great. They're really loud. We were told they were
really?
Going to be as well.
Are they rowdy?
It's the fans that it's not Inigo.
No, I'm sure you...
No, the actual
Filipino fans are crazy about you guys.
They're lovely. And also, and Inigo is such a good guy. We met him in London in the studio a couple of months ago, and we just like became mates.
Mm.
So to come over to Manila and hang out with him too is really cool.
Cool. So let's move on to the questions from your fans. Question number one. What's the strangest thing you've learned about each other on tour?
Nathan does this thing, and this is appropriate because we're in a bed, but Nathan...
Where is this going?
Nathan's always really cold all the time. He always just has the heating on in the house, which is like, it's way too hot. But if he's cold, before he's in bed, he'll get a hairdryer, and he'll just start blowing lots of hot air. Into his bed.
This isn't weird. This is a really good idea, and it's amazing that no one's caught on to this. I mean, here in the Philippines, it's too warm. Freezing. So, hairdryer in the bed, all snug as a bug in a rug.
A little bit weird.
So, you love the weather here in the Philippines?
I love it. I'm in a sweatshirt, and it's like, what's wrong with
you? I don't know what's wrong with you.
What about you, any strange thing?
Strange things? I'm actually trying to think. Isn't too strange, but you eat a lot of yogurt. You eat lots of yogurt every day.
You know what? Actually, now you said
probiotics.
You gotta take rest of the time. Nothing about the yawn because we're in a bed.
You do yawn quite a lot. Yeah, Brian's got this thing. He, I don't need to set an alarm in the mornings because he kind of just does this huge, obnoxious yawn. He's like, like that every morning.
That wakes you guys up.
Yeah. It's actually ridiculous. Like the room, like we live together in London, and I hear it every day, and it's like, the house shakes. So
I did it on the flight over to Philippines because I forgot I was on a flight.
Oh no!
I forgot I was on a plane, so I kind of just went. And then I realized everyone was looking at.
How many people woke up?
There was like a lot of people looking at me, like, "Okay, are you okay?"
I thought it was an engine problem.
All right.
Okay, next question. What is your favorite song to perform?
Like, among your songs.
Among us. Fix Somebody.
Fix Somebody.
Yeah, when we were on tour, Fix Somebody was used to come on and you do this thing at the end where we would climb down off the stage and get up on the barrier and we'd get the whole crowd to chant with us the Hey Ya bit. And That was very cool.
It's been great to play Fix and Body in the Philippines because a lot of people know it, which is amazing up here. So we can see people singing back the words to us. Yeah, it's great.
Awesome. That, you know, like what we say here in the Philippines, sample, sample,
sample. Okay, that's good.
Yeah, I heard that.
You bring that back to the UK.
Sample.
In like shops and stuff.
It means, you know, like, give me a snippet.
Sample.
We're doing a snippet.
It's the Filipino way of saying sample.
Sample.
That's Nathan.
That's
my
little boy. You've got a really small boy.
Yeah. Is that something? Are you guys comfortable? Just make yourselves comfortable enough to play the guitar.
Okay.
Don't worry about me.
I'm
just here.
I'm ready to join in.
This is a first for us.
Okay.
We've never played a song on a bed before. I might make a thing.
Every music video now we should be on a bed.
On a bed, yeah.
Yeah. Let's do it.
Okay. So this is our song, Fix Somebody. Ready for us?
It's really nice to hear a group of artists who can sing really well live, and I respect for that.
Thank you so much, man.
That's awesome.
Do you know an Ego song? That'll say yo.
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you know the words?
Not so much. So, okay, third question. How was working with Inigo?
Yeah, it was amazing, man. He's really, really cool and so talented as well. He's got such a voice on him. He kind of like, I remember the day that we turned up to do this. So we did a collab together. We mashed up Bad Guy and his song Options.
Uh-huh.
And the day that we all worked up, we were all just like in the studio, just like warming up, like, and he comes in and it's just easy, just a piece of cake, and the guy sings, sounds like an angel.
So we learned a bit of Daseo. It's kind of like, I guess, flex. Like, we had this idea that we'd do a video with, like, we did that, and then he'd do Fix Somebody.
Yeah.
And he learned Fix Somebody in like 5 minutes.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
He sounds much better than us on it as well.
Great.
He even got his own ad-libs in there that Ryan will sometimes do on stage.
Yeah.
Bringing the Inigo
ad-libs. Great hair.
Yeah, as I told you off camera a while ago, Inigo's father is a good friend of mine.
Club. We need a club.
Okay, fourth and last question from your fan. Do you have new rules for Valentine's?
Advice.
You're getting the advice. We're not very good at it. What we must have advice between this? What are we thinking?
flowers go a long way.
And cards.
Okay.
Just say they don't want cards and flowers.
Yeah.
Like, you always want cards and flowers.
Even a girly girl, oh sorry, a girl that says she isn't a girly girl, still likes
Oh, yes.
Yeah, there you go.
Okay.
Yeah, don't go to the movies. Don't
yeah.
do that, because like you don't talk, do you? Like you sit there and the film might be good, but afterwards, like, this was a nice exchange.
Really? It's hot in Manila.
Don't ask
the many over.
I disagree though. I disagree because I'm.
Well, I disagree with you.
No. Aside from being a singer, I'm also a director here in the
Oh, you are.
So
also,
I think
you're saying, buddy.
I know, right?
Take
a girl to
the
movie.
Take a girl to see his
film.
Specifically his
movie.
No. It depends. If it's like a horror movie.
Yeah,
it's up to you.
Oh my god, I'm so scared! You can't
do
the line, is where you can go with the.
Both making a move on
it? What's important is the dinner after the movie. And you can discuss.
Well, that's
you know,
a good question.
Yeah,
it's time to talk about.
Or dinner during. Did you ever do that? You sneak Jollibees underneath.
Jollibee
the spaghetti.
Jollibee in the cinema, yeah. Spaghetti in the cinema is a good one.
Oh, sweet spaghetti is
classic.
Yeah.
So, tons.
Alright, okay, so we've come to this really quick segment of the show. This is called the This or That segment. I'm gonna. And then you just choose. No explanations.
Cool.
Right? Hey. Okay. First, wine or beer?
Beer.
Of course.
But yeah.
Of course.
With
yeah.
the sport.
Sports.
Sports and beer.
Okay. Two, hugs or kisses?
Kisses, baby.
Kisses.
I'm gonna go hugs just to be different.
Yeah, he's a very good hugger.
No explanations.
Text or video?
Video. Confuses me.
Why are you laughing? Okay.
Texts?
Video.
I don't get it, but I'm gonna say video.
Okay. Form or function?
Form.
Form?
Form.
Oh!
Sorry about the questions, guys. Yeah, but you're kind of the legal age already, right?
Oh, listen.
Okay.
Keep it going.
Okay.
Mental age.
Giver or receiver?
Oh, giver. Receiver.
Yes. Your place or theirs?
Oh, your place.
Yeah,
my
your
place.
Theirs.
Our
and
place?
Dip. Our place.
We would do share
ours.
Yeah, come to my house.
My child.
Rough or gentle?
Go hard or go home. Rough.
Wait, gentle?
Gentle.
Oh, he's
definitely
a receiver.
I'm a gentle receiver.
Okay. Screamer or moaner?
Oh,
you have a bit of a story about this, actually.
Yeah.
No,
yeah.
I don't.
I don't think you should go into it.
Wait, what?
No, last night.
What?
Alex.
Wow!
Yeah.
Yes. Not me. It doesn't
matter.
I had to put earbuds in last night because someone, it was happy hour next door
mm-hmm.
in the hotel.
Mm.
They were partying all night.
Yes, hugging very, very hard.
Okay. And he heard some screams.
Oh,
and
yeah.
Oh.
And I needed earbuds. I didn't want to stop them. They were having fun.
Okay, so screamer or moaner?
Screaming. You're gonna go for it, aren't you?
Screaming.
Mom.
Yeah.
Okay, last one. Journey or destination?
Journey.
Destination.
Okay.
Yeah, destination.
Oh,
I'll get there really quick.
Okay, so that's about it, guys. Is there do you have like last words for your fans out there? Like maybe invite them to follow you on your social media
yeah.
accounts. And
sure. Yeah. First off, salamat sa suporta.
Yeah,
that's
awesome.
So
that's awesome.
Want to say lots of love to you. Thank you for, you're the reason we're here, so massive thanks you for that. And social media, man.
Yeah, follow us on Instagram at New Rules, Twitter at New Rules Tweets, and TikTok, we know you all have TikTok, at New Rules Band.
We want to come back really soon, so
yeah.
Come to shows and stuff.
I was looking at this camera the whole time. Was I meant to...
Wait, is it that one or this one?
Is it that?
It's both.
Oh, it's both.
Yeah, yeah.
Just look right in the middle of it.
Split your eyes.
All right,
we love you guys.
Lots of love.
Right, okay, again, thank you guys for joining us on our not really sexy, but naughty conversations. And again, if you miss this episode, we will be uploading our website, and that's lifestyle.abs-cbn.com. And also follow us on all our social media accounts. That's at ABS-CBN Lifestyle on Instagram and Twitter.
What the? Where are you?
Okay. So, again, thank you. Thank you to everyone who made today. Wait, you just shook my brain, bro. Thank you to everyone who made today's episode possible. Thank you to Red Doors for having us. And thank you, Team MVP, for our grooming. And once again, see you on our next episode. And remember,
this is just pillow talk.
Oh my god. Hey. Got it. Okay, can we do it again?
Yeah. All together.
And just remember,
this is just pillow talk, baby.
Wink, wink. All right. Thanks, man.
Hey.
That's awesome.
Thank you.